Oké, hallo. Welcome back by my videos. This video I will show you how to build a Newman motor. In a proper way and with the proper tools. I've been busy with prefabricating some things, and I will go slowly over it, what is all the parts. And everything you will see here is everything you need to make a successful motor that can spin like this one. This one is already spinning now for 3 days, so it's a very nice motor or engine. So let's go over the parts. First, to begin, make this out of a small PVC. I can show you a bit what is the diameter. So this is the diameter. It's like a 4.5. What you have to do is cut it really precise, because otherwise it's not gonna be correct on the wood. It's gonna be like this or like this or like that, and you want to have it straight. Another thing is, you have to drill a hole that is exactly the opposite of the other side. You can do that when you have the correct measurements of where you're gonna place the shaft. Like this, then you can take with a pen, you can mark it. For the rest, I have some small holes here, which you can see on my bigger version, that it is very nice to keep the cylinder. I do this with as I can with plastic, because all iron things around the motor are just things that may slow it down. Okay, wooden blocks. These wooden blocks are coming like this, so you can have a nice distance. These are 6 nail magnets, very strong magnets. 2 little screws like this. These are necessary when I'm gonna stick the magnet to the coil or to the shaft. You need some spacers to let the magnets not stand equally straight like this. So you can place there on top, you can place the magnets, so they don't swivel around. If you got the magnet proper in place, then you can start gluing or all these kind of things. If you're gonna do it low power and not really full power yet, then you won't need any glue, because the magnets will stay on the shaft. Okay, to make the coil, you need a magnet wire, and I'm really not a fan of driving for any kind of little piece that I need to the radio shack. I even hate these people, because they always have a big mouth over what you have to buy or what you have to do. So I just open up a transformer, and it's some work, but it pays off. Free wire. I do this already for years. That's why you can see this big stack of electronic parts here. Maybe 10% of what I have here is original, bought in a radio shack or something. Okay, these are some optional things. I took them from some RC cars, very nice metallic parts, because I want to use this motor also for some load tests. And the shaft, I make a little gap here, so I can screw this thing on and use the power of the motor for something. Need some of these things to connect the commutator, to connect the wires that has to go into the coil, an electric switch to put it on and off. You don't need big wire, so the best wire I suggest is telephone wire, or solid copper telephone wire, very important, solid copper. Here I have some biopolar capacitors rating 100 volt 10 microfarads. I'm gonna bind them together to get a higher voltage, and that's gonna go across the coil. I will show you later how all the electrical things are connected. For the rest, you need some tape, some tie wraps, a ruler, a CD pen, a wire cutter, a small crosshead screwdriver, and a big one, some glue, and some measurement tool. You also might need a multimeter, but that's for later stadium, and I forgot. These are ball bearing holders, also used from parts that I had from my radiographic cars. They're actually identical, so they are not mirrorized, so I'm gonna use them like that, this one, that, so to get the same opposite view. Well, in my next video I will show you the build up from it. I'm gonna go to a next stage, and that is like a raw setup of the big materials, the coil, the ball bearing holders, and the shaft. Okay. Well, see you in the next video.